Hey guys, Michael here, and I'm back to talk bricks. Today we're talking LEGO Marvel Super Heroes, and figuring out, should you buy the Thanos Ultimate Battle Set? For the weekly giveaway, simply comment and subscribe, and you could win a prize. Here we have the Thanos Ultimate Battle Set. It retails for $69.99 and contains 674 pieces, with four minifigures, including the Big Fig for Thanos and the Infinity Gauntlet. But with six sets in the Infinity War line, many of you guys are asking, is it worth it? So let's break everything down. While this ship has a very similar design to the Milano from the previous Guardians of the Galaxy movies, this ship is only referred to as the Guardian ship in the LEGO description. And while I definitely thought this would feel like a huge repeat of the ships that we've gotten, this one actually felt pretty fresh. And a lot of that for me had to do with the build for the wings. Interestingly, they have an upward tilt, and I really like all the graphic details with the gray and orange design. At the front of each wing, we've got this nice sticker detail, a light, as well as a stud shooter, and the edges of the wings have two sections that can actually be posed up and down. The build underneath has a nice slope design, and I like the way they created those intakes. From the back here, we can see this subtle build of some boosters, and on the bottom, we've got these colorful dishes. At the front, we can see the cockpit, and that opening hatch is the exact same piece that we got in the Guardians of the Galaxy 2 line. And with the windshield opened up, you only have limited access to the characters. For full access, lift up the entire front of the ship, and then pull out this small little speeder. It's unclear if we'll ever see this speeder in the movie, but there are weapons racks on both sides, and it can seat two figures. At the very back, there's a small gray peg that plugs into these red clips on the inside of the ship, and it's easy enough to put them on back in. The top of the ship also features some additional stickers to add detail, and the entire top can be removed to see inside. In this center compartment, there are spots for two figures, as well as some sticker detail on either side. At the rear of the ship, we've got these two additional fins that can be posed, and the entire rear compartment can open up. On the inside, it's fairly empty, but you can see one jumper plate, which actually holds the Infinity Gauntlet. The Infinity Gauntlet piece simply rests on this brick-built stand. There's sticker detail at the bottom of the base, and there are six spots in the glove for the individual Infinity Stones. Here we can see the Reality Stone. And this set actually includes three spares. And to place the Infinity Gauntlet in the ship, simply slot it into place and close up the rear hatch. If you also have the set Thor's Weapon Quest, this ship can create a combined form with the pod included in that set. To combine the ships, start by lifting these flaps at the back, then slot in the ship and attach it using the peg at the bottom. There are two stickered connectors that lock it into place, and then simply lower those flaps. And to complete the look, close up the rear fins. And here you can see everything all locked into place. It's a really cool look, and it adds a lot of fun playability to actually both of these sets. The color scheme allows the ships to meld so perfectly, and it's really cool having a character looking out of the rear. And from the front, you almost can't even tell that the pod's there, as it blends in seamlessly. And onto the set's four minifigures, starting with the Big Fig for Thanos. This Big Fig uses the exact same Thanos mold that we got in the Avenged Space Mission set, and this honestly feels like a bit of a miss to me. Taking the head and shoulders aside, the rest of the print and the coloring looks exactly how I would want it to. And there's no major detail on the back. Thanos' weapon here is a large sword piece, and it does kind of look like a butter knife to me. But the real fun is when you swap out his left hand for the Infinity Gauntlet. And overall, I'd say LEGO did a pretty nice job with this design, as it just slots where the normal hand does. We see the red Reality Stone at the center of the gauntlet here, but there are open spots for all six stones. While they're not laid out exactly how they would be in the comics, I think they had to do this for playability. And my only slight complaint is how open it is at the bottom. Next up, we've got the Iron Man Mark 50. And while the figure isn't exclusive to this set, the neck attachment with these large boosters is. This build takes advantage of the Outrider neck piece, as well as some slopes and stickers. But what really sets it off is all those new blue Power Blast pieces. And you even build some of them together to create the Repulsor Blast we can see coming out of his hands. And you can also swap them out for these ones. And while these additional boosters are far larger than they are in the movie, I think it is a fun look for a toy. The print for the armor looks really nice, including the triangle-shaped arc reactor at the center. Lifting the front of the mask open, you can see Tony's really great new face, featuring the heads-up display. And on the other side, he's got this additional smiling face. From the rear, you can see the neck attachment and how the pieces all hook on, And with that removed, you can see a really nice continuation of the print from the front. Next up, we've got Star-Lord, and this is the exact same version that we got from Guardians of the Galaxy 2. While the print on the torso is nice, it's certainly not as updated as it could be. And while the face does feature two alternate expressions, the newer Chris Pratt face from Jurassic World would have been a much nicer choice. From the side here, you can see his two unique blaster pieces, and from the back, there's a simple continuation of the print from the front. And finally, we do have an exclusive version of Gamora. And this might be my favorite version we've gotten of her yet. She's in her classic look, and the print that continues onto the legs is really nice. There are purple details printed in the hair, and she's got the nice silver details on the face, with the other face being more aggressive. From the side, we can see her trademark sword accessory, and from the back, there's a really nice continuation of the details from the front. So now that we've reviewed everything, it comes back to the original question. Is this set worth it? I definitely went into this set a little bit skeptical, as I didn't want to just build another Milano. But I was actually quite pleasantly surprised. The build had some really nice techniques, especially with the way that they did the wings. And the fact that it combines with the ship from the other set really makes this a fun value for the two of them. Minifigure-wise, I'm a little disappointed we didn't get a new Star-Lord, and I definitely think the Thanos was a bit of a miss. But that being said, he is exclusive, and there's a really nice version of Iron Man and a brand new version of Gamora that I think are hard to pass up. And this one's going to be hard to skip, as it's the only set with Thanos and the Infinity Gauntlet, as well as the Red Reality Stone. So for me, this set is definitely worth it. But definitely let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Do you think this set is worth it? And be sure to leave this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw, and don't forget to subscribe, because I've got more Infinity War sets and 2018 set news coming soon. And remember, for my weekly giveaways, simply comment and subscribe, and you could win a prize. You must be a subscriber to win, and definitely turn on notifications to find out when my next video is posted, because I'll be announcing the winners at the end of some of the videos. That's all the time we've got for today. Thanks, and have a good one! Hey guys, Michael here. We're going to find out if the Outrider Dropship Attack set is worth it, and don't forget to subscribe.